अब हमारे साथ एक और खास मेहमान बसंता कुमार कार हैं, रेसिपिएंट ग्लोबल न्यूट्रिशन लीडरशिप अवार्ड। धन्यवाद जुड़ने के लिए सर। आप ये बताइए, जो ये पैंडेमिक का असर हुआ है, इसमें हमने टीकाकरण की बात की, लेकिन पोषण पर बहुत अहम असर है। आंगनबाड़ी का भी जिक्र सुना हमने डॉक्टर, जिस तरह से मिस्टर शंकर ने बताया। आप ये बताइए सर कि किस तरह से हम पहले हालात में पहुंचेंगे, पोषण हमारे बच्चों को मिलेगा, आंगनबाड़ी क्योंकि इससे बहुत प्रभावित हुई है।
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ब्रिंगिंग मी हियर। आई थिंक गुड न्यूट्रिशन इज गुड लाइफ एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस पैंडेमिक टाइम वी हैव रियलाइज्ड दैट इट इज आल्सो एपीपी पर्सनल प्रोटेक्शन इक्विपमेंट। ड्यूरिंग दिस पैंडेमिक न्यूट्रिशन डिसरप्शन हैज हैपेंड एंड यू आर अवेयर दैट एट द आंगनबाड़ी सेंटर देयर यूज्ड टू बी विलेज हेल्थ एंड न्यूट्रिशन डे and women used to get antenatal services including blood pressure checkup and many other things, and there was immunization vaccination, and moreover there was also supplementary nutrition, and for many poor it was a full meal. So because of the disruption there is an effect on life, livelihood, and also effect on the pandemic areas, and infection has been compounded. And within that effect, women and children are the hardest hit. And specifically, India, you are aware that India is home to 1/3 of the stunted children, and also India has highest number of wasted children. And around 9.5 million children are from the severely affected malnourished category, who used to be referred to nutrition rehabilitation centers. And since nutrition rehabilitation centers in many places have been affected, so the life and livelihood, basically the survival and the life of the children, of the severely affected malnourished children have been affected. And pregnant mother, you know that they need additional meal, they need rest during pregnancy. And because of the gender-based violence has been increased, and evidence suggests that it has a bearing on stunting and also low birth weight. So overall, there is a lot of effect because of this pandemic. Government has tried to address those effects. There is also cash system. There is also home contact, and there is also delivery by Anganwadi workers and ASHA workers at the doorstep. But still, because of the disruption, the things have been affected, and specifically, the Poshan Abhiyan, the way it was envisaged, the way it was rolling on, that has been affected. And another incidental effect is the effect on SDG 2, Sustainable Development Goal, and on the World Health Assembly target. Because India's target or India's achievement is dependent on global achievement, global target. So overall, not only India has been affected, but the global target has been affected on nutrition front.
Sir, you work with the Coalition for Food and Nutrition Security. How has their work been affected in this period?
In fact, because of the curfew, lockdown, so people are not able to visit Anganwadi centers. And one important thing that happens at Anganwadi centers in the convergence, both ASHA worker, ANM, and Anganwadi worker used to come in one day in a month. They used to provide both nutrition and health services. So our volunteers are not able to work with them. Then social mobilization processes have been affected. Then self-help group, panchayats, people who used to go, their services also have been affected. And overall, there is a disruption on supplies and services at the ground.
Yeah, no, there would be. Then that would be such a cause of concern. Sir, thank you so much for being with us this evening on such an important telethon. Thank you very much indeed.